So are you airbrushing like this, which is creating lots of clogging and spattering, and you're getting frustrated and you don't know why? Well, in this video, I'm gonna show you how to airbrush the right way. Let's get into it right now. Whether your airbrush is a gravity or a siphon feed airbrush, and you find yourself airbrushing like this, then you're doing it wrong. You can see I've got uneven strokes and I've also got some spattering. Now this is happening because I'm not using my double action correctly. The key to using your double action airbrush correctly is to press down for air and pull back for paint. Keeping that air pressed down at all times. The more you pull back, the more paint will come out. The less you pull back, the less paint will come out. Therefore, the trigger will allow you to adjust how fine or broad the spray will be. What you don't want to do is paint like this. If you hear that air going on and off, then you're not using your double action airbrush correctly. So with a single action airbrush, you actually press down and you'll get air and paint at the same time. You control the stroke, meaning how thick or thin it goes, usually by a dial or a little adjustment on the front of the airbrush. It is easier to master a single action brush, and they definitely do have their place within airbrushing. I personally don't use one because I'm doing more artwork, and for artwork, a double action airbrush is far superior. It will be trickier to master, but once you do master it, then you can do all sorts of artwork. You're not as limited as when you are using a single action. So now to demo the correct use of the airbrush, pressing down for air, pulling back for paint, and you want to move with your stroke. And it's paint on, paint off. Paint on, paint off. So what I'm doing is paint on, paint off, meaning that that trigger is returning back to the start position. Therefore, by doing that, what you're doing is not allowing any of that paint to get stuck within the fluid nozzle, which will also create more rapid tip drying. You may just be able to see some of that tip drying occurring. So demonstrating now the incorrect way, pulling back, letting go, painting like that and letting go all the time, not returning the trigger to the start position. And the other thing that that can cause is when I press down for air, you're going to get a spurt of paint that will come out and it can potentially ruin your artwork. So always remember to keep that air pressed down at all times and pull back on the paint. And then when you finish your stroke, return that trigger back to the start position. So paint on, paint off, paint on, paint off, paint on, paint off. To fast track your airbrushing, you can definitely check out our online airbrushing course at airbrushasylum.thinkific.com. It's going to be harder to master, but it will allow you to do all types of artwork once you get the feel for it. If you use it incorrectly, then you're never going to have that sort of control that you need when doing really high detailed work. And you can see that tip drying starting to form. Even though I was using it correctly just then, the airbrushing from before has already accelerated my tip drying. You're gonna have more trouble with clogging and spattering if you don't use your double action correctly. So once you've mastered your double action and you're keeping that air pressed down at all times and just pulling back for paint, the next thing you need to know that in order to create a broad spray or a fine line, three things come into play. Your height, so the distance you are from the surface. So the further you are away from the surface, the broader the spray. The paint flow, so how much you're pulling back on that trigger. So if I'm far away, like in this case, I'm about 15 to 20 centimeters away, and I'm only pulling back a little bit on the trigger, and I'm moving relatively slowly, then I'm getting a nice soft spray. So this is perfect for shading and just backgrounds to build them up, even blends. If I want to go heavier, then I'm pulling back full throttle on that trigger, which would look like this. And you can see I'm immediately getting coverage and it doesn't take long to build up at all. If you want to do lines, like say you're outlining something, then you need to keep your height consistent and the speed consistent. If I start from here and I start slow and then I speed up and then I slow down again, you can see I'm getting these heavier sections. So by keeping that air press down pulling back on the paint and moving in a consistent speed as well as a consistent height from the surface, I'm able to get a nice consistent line. If it starts doing that, that's not because of the inconsistency with my height or my speed. That is just because I'm starting to get some tip drying and it's obstructing my paint flow. So just taking another look now from a different angle, keeping that air press down at all times, pulling back for paint, doing some finer lines, broader spray. Don't be afraid to come back further from your surface. It's going to feel a bit strange because you're not touching the surface when you're airbrushing. But you can see how nice and smooth I can get my lines by keeping all of those factors consistent. And even when doing dots, I still like to be up nice and close, and I'm keeping that air on at all times, just pulling back on my trigger to create those fine dots. And a good way to practice the double action technique is to get yourself just a book like this or anything with lots of different words in it, and then keeping the air press down, go ahead and cross out the words. If you want, do every second word, keeping that air press down. If you miss one, don't worry too much about it. Just keep going. You can see I'm doing sort of every second, every third. I'm not varying my height. I missed a bit there. This is pretty small text, but it'll force you to concentrate. I'm gonna drop the airflow down a little bit using my MAC valve. If you don't have this feature on your airbrush, it's fine. You can drop your PSI on your compressor and overthin your paint. Okay, so here we go. So you can see, not really that consistent with every second word, but it is pretty difficult. You could tell I wasn't speaking while I was doing it because I had to really concentrate, but reasonably consistent all around with my strokes as well. So if you just do something like this, then you can evaluate it at the end and see how you've gone. And it's really good practice because it does force you to keep that air on and just pull back for paint. The one thing you don't want to do is do a stroke, then move to the next one, do a stroke, do the next one. You want to keep moving like this, nice and smooth, and don't stop. Even if you make a mistake, just don't stop, keep going. Because the idea is to cross out the words, and you can probably print yourself something that's a bit easier than this. This is pretty difficult, but it gives you an idea of an exercise that you can do to really practice and hone your double action skills.